Hello, I trust that you're doing well. Welcome to Miss Fountain Channel, your go-to destination for insightful and engaging educational content. Here, we explore a range of topics from science and history to technology and beyond. Prepare to expand your knowledge and spark your curiosity with our carefully crafted videos. Subscribe now and join us on our journey of discovery. In today's session, we're going to look at the Hardy-Weinberg Principle. I'm going to begin with a brief introduction. This model, that is the Hardy-Weinberg principle, is based on the fundamental framework of Mendelian segregation of diploid organisms that are reproducing sexually in combination with the fundamental principles of probability. This model has various assumptions. And they include 1. Random mating. There is neither preference for nor aversion to the union in the choices of mates. Second assumption is no mutation. We assume that genetic information is transmitted from parent to progeny without change. Mutations provide the genetic variability. That is our primary concern in genetics. The third assumption is a large population size. That's a self-explanatory point. The fourth assumption is a no natural selection. We will assume that there is no differential survival or reproduction of individuals with different genotypes. The fifth assumption of Hardy-Weinberg principle is no migration. And in this, we'll assume that we're dealing with a single isolated population. There's no migration, there's no leaving the population, and there's no coming in the population. The sixth assumption is the organism is diploid. And the seventh assumption is reproduction is asexual. That is, as opposed to clonal. Some other assumptions of the Hardy-Weinberg principle of the model is generations are discrete and non-overlapping. The locus under consideration has two alleles. Allele frequencies are identical among all mating types, that is the sexes. Also, there is a random union of gametes. It's important to note that there are two important consequences of this assumption. And the first one is that the population will not evolve. Mendelian inheritance has no inherent tendency to favor one allele. Therefore, allele and genotype frequencies will remain constant from generation to generation. That is in accordance to Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. And the second important consequence of these assumptions is the genotype frequencies will be in binomial, that is Hardy-Weinberg proportions. That is, genotypic frequencies after one generation of random mating will be a binomial function of allele frequencies. Hardy-Weinberg principle allows us to describe a population by the frequencies of the alleles at a locus rather than by the many different genotypes that can occur at a single diploid locus. I'm going to quickly look at Hardy-Weinberg proportions. In our case, we have the dominant allele, that is the homozygote. And also have the heterozygote. Okay, we have a capital A's representing our dominant homozygote. We have a heterozygote. Then we have our recessive homozygote. And the total. We can explain this that each homozygote, that is the A capitals and the small a's contains two copies of the same allele, while each heterozygote, our heterozygote is the one with a capital A and small a, contains one copy of each of its constituent. And therefore, the allele frequencies are P, that is the frequency of A, the dominant. We have the formula right there with us, that is into brackets, two copies of the dominant allele, that is a 2N11, plus a single copy of the heterozygous divided by the total. The same applies for Q, where you're going to work with the single copy of the heterozygote and two copies of the homozygote, the recessive one, that is small a, divided by the total. This will end up giving us a genotypic proportion, whereby we have P plus Q squared is going to give us P squared plus 2PQ plus Q squared. You can work this out using a Punnett square. It's going to take you there step by step. It's important to note that these proportions will be reached in one generation, providing all of the above assumptions, or provided all the above assumptions are met, and allele frequencies are equal in males and females. These genotypic frequencies will be maintained forever as long as these assumptions hold. The Hardy-Weinberg principle can be readily extended to more than two alleles with two simple rules. And the first rule is the expected frequency of homozygotes for any allele is the square of the frequency of that allele. And the second rule is the expected frequency of any heterozygote is twice the product of the two alleles present in the heterozygote. And this is just what you've explained, the rules. And that's what you're gonna end up with. That is a P plus Q plus R squared. I forgot to put a squared. It's P plus Q plus R squared is going to give you P squared plus 2PQ plus Q squared plus 2PR plus 2QR plus R squared. These formulas are actually important because you're going to need them in some of the calculations in genetics. Yeah, that's briefly.